If you have a new vehicle with keyless entry, keyless start, or keyless go, then you may have heard of all the vehicle thefts happening using a method called a relay attack.
Check out this security video clip on the Toronto City News article talking about an actual relay attack used to steal this SUV. Contrary to what the caption says, the relay attack does not disable the car security system. What actually happens is the criminals only use readily available tools bought online to relay the signals from the key fob located in the house back to the vehicle. Doing this allows the SUV to detect the key fob as if it was right next to it. This allows the criminals to unlock the doors, start it, and drive off even without physical access to the keys.
If you are concerned about this, then you will want to have your keys stored in a proper Faraday box when at home. While you may have heard of advice to use a metal box, aluminum foil, or even a microwave to store your keys in, they don't necessarily work well and are not that practical. Metal boxes can leak a small amount of signal that can be amplified by the relay attack tools and need to be tested before you use them. Aluminum foil can work if enough layers are wrapped around, but it is unsightly and cumbersome to use. And note that as you use and reuse the foil over time, holes and tears can form that leak the radio frequency signals.
And lastly, a microwave doesn't work to protect your keys.
Now, this brings us to making your own Faraday box for a home that actually works. Frakking Creations, showing you the good stuff on DIY Faraday boxes.
By the way, if you need a portable Faraday box or bag for when you are out and about, then check out our DIY videos on making these cool pocket-sized Faraday box and Faraday bag. If you also want to stop key cloning attacks, check out our OBD port lock video too.
What box to use? I'm going to use this cool box I have for this project. You can use any box or container of your liking, from metal boxes, cash boxes, to different types of book boxes and book safes of your liking. That's what's great about this project. You can use your favorite box and make it into a Faraday cage to protect your key fob and vehicle. You just need to make sure you seal the box from any radio frequency leakage and test it out properly. Throughout the process, we are going to use this app to test for leakage of cell, Bluetooth, and Wi-Fi radio signals. You can do the same too. Find links to the Android and iOS apps in the video description below. I will also test the box out using the key fob. You need to properly test your box out because it is very easy for a small opening to leak enough signal that can be picked up and defeat the purpose of the box. I had to make modifications to the original design after testing revealed that the box was still leaking some RF signals. Find out how I solved the problem later in this video. If you need to, you can skip to the chapter of interest using the chapters feature in the playback bar or in the description. This includes the testing chapters too. Look for links to any resources and products I talk about in our video description below. What shielding material to use? You could do this project using aluminum foil, copper tape, or special Faraday fabric like this. It's up to you. I chose this Titan RF Faraday fabric since they have been lab tested, plus it has a nice finish. It's a nicely woven fabric made of about 25% metallic copper, 13% nickel, and 62% polyester, so it's pretty easy to work with. Plus, you also get a small strip of conductive Faraday fabric tape, which is pretty useful. There is a helpful information sheet that is provided too. It gives you tips for your Faraday enclosure projects, and also some testing information on your fabric. You can see in this chart the different frequencies that have been tested, and the amount of signal reduction, or attenuation, a single, double, or triple layers of fabric are able to provide. First attempt. I measure, draw out, and cut out one piece of the Faraday fabric that will fold up into the shape of the inside of the box. There are tabs to overlap the corners and the lip of the box to close up any holes that could leak any signals. There is also an additional shielded panel added to the lid which will close into the box when the lid is closed. This will hopefully reduce signals that could leak around the opening. Testing first attempt. At this point, the box looks great, but we need to test. I get some baseline readings for cell, Bluetooth, and Wi-Fi signal strength before sealing the smartphone with the app running into the box. The test is run for about 30 seconds. We see that only the cell signals are blocked. Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are still getting through. Note that the Wi-Fi router and Bluetooth speaker used for the test are in the same room, which means that the signal strengths are quite high. If you look at the tip sheet provided, it mentions that even the tiniest hole can leak signal, and that high-strength signals like Wi-Fi may require two or three layers of fabric on all sides for it to be blocked completely. The single layer of shielding is not enough, so back to the drawing board to improve the shielding. Second attempt. I decide to add additional shielded side and bottom panels to the inside of the box. I'm also hoping that the side panels will work with the inner lid panel to better seal the opening. Testing second attempt. Testing reveals that both Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are still able to get through, so I use some aluminum foil to test sealing the lid better to see if that is the cause. It looks like that helps block Bluetooth now, so only Wi-Fi left to deal with. Third attempt. I decide to add another layer around the inside of the box and to further improve the sealing around the lid. This time, for the inner layer, I will use one piece of fabric and fold it into a box shape without any cuts. This continuous sheet will ensure the corners are not leaking signals. After taping this new inner layer into the box and reinstalling the five inner side and bottom panels, I retest. Testing third attempt. Unfortunately, testing reveals that Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are still not fully blocked. It looks like the lid is still the main culprit. I verify this by pressing down on the lid while testing, and we then get the desired result. When testing the FOB, it also shows that the signal leak is coming from the front of the box. Final modification. Before making any final modifications, I'm going to test using the bottom panel as an inner lid. This may be enough to resolve the leak issue at the top. Testing reveals that this works, and so I will finalize the design this way. Final test of the Faraday book box. After the final modifications are complete, a test reveals that the box is now able to block cell, Bluetooth, and Wi-Fi signals even when we are in the same room as the Wi-Fi router and Bluetooth speaker. Conductance test. One thing that is important to remember as you are making your own Faraday box or enclosure is that all the sides of the box must maintain conductivity in order to form a proper Faraday cage. If one side is not conductive with the rest of the box, then it really isn't a Faraday cage. So we can test the resistance throughout all panels using a multimeter to make sure. The resistance within the probe and fabric is about 0.4 ohms of resistance, so it should be the same throughout the box as well if constructed properly. There you go, some great info for you to use in making your own DIY Faraday box. Make sure whatever you make to fully test it using the app and a multimeter. You should also test the box is able to block whatever signal you are attempting to block using the actual device. In our case, a key fob. If you enjoyed our video, please consider helping our channel grow by subscribing, liking, and also sharing our videos with friends and family. Thanks for watching.